the last 4 or 5 days, I've had a number of people ask for some help on how to prepare the images for submission. So what I've done, rather than me write individual emails, takes me a bit of time, but also, which I think is better so you can see, is I've put together this short video clip to walk you through how to first, if it's in a RAW format, change it from RAW to JPEG, and then to change the image to the correct aspect ratio or the same shape, 8x10 or 10x8 or 5x5. Then how to retitle the image in accordance with the rules, so it's got Summer 17, the title of the image, and then your name. And then also when you send the image, to make sure it's in the correct size, i.e. it's between 2 and 4 megabytes image information. Okay, so they're the steps. I hope this helps. So any problems, please get back to me. Good luck. I'm still very bribeable. Cash or cake or both ensures you win. Cheers. Here we are in my folder system, and we can see on the top left side I've got photos to sort out, and I've got a folder under the summer photo composition for 2017. I've got a submissions, and this is my demo folder. In there I have a picture I've selected that I want to enter into the photo competition. Now the problem is the extension of this file, or the dot and the letters after it, NEF, tells me that's a Nikon RAW file and you cannot submit RAW files to the competition. So what we need to do is convert that. And I'm going to use one of the editing softwares that I've got on the computer. Lots of different ones will allow you to do this. But if I go on the picture, it's highlighted, light blue box, right click, come down to, not open at the top, but down to open with. When I hover over that, it lists and shows the various editing software I have available on the computer. There is the Photos one, which comes free with this particular Windows system. So you might have the same on your computer or the Apple version, but I'm gonna actually use Photoshop Elements 14 editor, much the same as them. Now what's happened there is a window opened quickly overlaid by this one. Because it's a RAW file, it opens up in this separate light grey window, and at the top left corner it tells me it's a Camera RAW Nikon D300. That's the camera I took this picture on. I can do some basic editing over on the right hand side, but all I want to do at the moment is convert this picture from RAW file to a JPEG. And all I need to do is go to the bottom right corner, click on the open image, and it then opens it up in the Photoshop Elements window. Again, there's some basic editing options on the right hand side, but as I said, I want to convert it to JPEG. So we come up to the top toolbar where it says file, excuse me, come down to save as, window opens, it's going to save the file to the submissions demo where I want it to go, and we make sure the save as type is in JPEG, or the file type you wish to use within the rules of the competition. And then above it is the same file name. I click save, and because it's a RAW, it can change into a JPEG file. For the JPEG options for quality, because this has not been cropped or edited yet, we want to keep it at full quality. So you can either type in here a number, or drag the slidey bar, but you want the largest file, which it says here. And after a short delay, the actual file size will be displayed on the right hand side. For this particular one, it's 10.5 megabytes of information. If I drag this to the left, you can see it's going to change to something less. There, it's less than 1 megabyte. But a moment, because we've not edited it, we want the full quality for the JPEG image, 10.5, quality 12, that fully to the right. Click OK. And it's now, if I go back to my folder, what we can see in the submissions demo folder, there's the original, and it's actually now saved a copy of it but converted to JPEG. Notice it got the same names, DJC_1979, DJC_1979. So it's the same picture, but this is saved in a RAW format and this one's saved in a JPEG format. Don't worry about this extra folder, that's the software editing system just creating a little folder for some of the settings it looks after later. So now we've got the image saved to JPEG. What I want to do now is open this JPEG image, right, mate, keep it highlighted, right click, come down to not the top one, but come down to open with. I'm using my elements window. It's opened the image up now. There she is. Now this is the Photoshop elements. All the editing softwares are very, very similar. This one's got the quick version window, which has got a small number of tools down the left-hand side and some basic editing options on the right. If I go to the expert, you can see we've got far more, it's just rendering, far more tools to play with on the left-hand side. So there's a lot more editing that can be done. So what we want to do is we need to get the file. Now it's in JPEG. I'll say that you've edited it. I can't demonstrate because I don't know what editing you'd want to do, but we've edited the picture how we want it. And we now need to crop it and make it the right shape for the competition or the aspect ratio. So what we need to do is find the crop tool, which is over on the left-hand side here. I'll click off it a minute, come over it, click on that. And when I click on it, across the bottom is the options for the crop tool. It's like two interlacing right-hand corners. When I click on this symbol, what appears over my actual full picture, which is grayed out, except for the area where this crop's going to be at the moment. I can drag it around using the cursor. And at the moment, you can see it's like in a portrait. If I come down here to the crop, it's 8x10. And we can show that the width is 8, the height is 10, so it is portrait. But if I click on this thing in between, it changes it between 10 and 8. So it's like a landscape, and we can see across top here, drag it around, we've got 10 across by 8 up. Now, if your system was not defaulted to 10 by 8, if you look at just above it, this drop-down option, there's the other aspect ratios. No restriction, you can drag it to whatever shape you want. But for this competition, it needs to be in the 8x10 or 10x8. And as we see in a moment, square or 5x5. We're doing the 8x10. Sorry about that. And we can see we got it in a portrait, 10x8, 10 units across, 8 up. I can drag it around. I can change the size. It's what's actually good, clear image part is what would be left if I crop the image now. So if I just wanted the bottom left-hand corner, I can drag it in there. I can move these around, or if I just want the pink and white flowers. This is, again, your personal editing. But let's see, I like the yellow flowers in the bottom left-hand corner. Let's bring it up to the right. Yes, I like that. I'm not so keen on this bit of gravel here, so I'll just drag it back down the top. What I'm doing is I'm removing some of this green here, but trying to keep as much as the colour, the lilac coloured top left, yellow bottom left, and these pinks, whites and reds on the bottom right. So I'm going to drag the top right corner down, just so we've still got the pink head there, yellow in the bottom, got these colours here, still got a bit of tarmac, but there's a bit of green space here, so I'm just going to drag that up the bottom, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this corner in, there, and it's just that. You can see the whole picture. If you want, you can actually, you may prefer that. That's personal choice. You may prefer this. Whatever, you put it to where you want. And when you've got the area you would like to be including your picture in the 10x8 aspect ratio, you click on the tick or the OK button. And now we've got the cropped part of the picture as our displayed image. And I'm saying I'm quite happy. If you don't like that, you can always go up to the edit, undo the crop, put it back to the previous full size image. You can start again. But I like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do file, save as. And in this window, check it's the type JPEG still. File name still there. But what I'm going to do while I'm sorting these pictures out, I'm just going to add to the file name before the dot JPG, I'm going to add dash and it's 10x8, 10 times 8 aspect ratio. So I've got pictures 90, 79, 10x8, save, And we can see now JPEG options, the quality at 12, the highest quality has dropped because we cut some of the picture off and it's 6 by 5 megabytes of information. Now, this is the point to change it, because what we need for the competition is to be between 2 and 4 megabytes. I can type in there, but what I find is just drag the cursor to the left on the slider bar, 2.9, well, it's 2 to 4, so let's see if we can go a bit higher. 11 is 4.1, so that's a bit too much. Go to 10, 2.9, that's between 2 and 4 megabytes required for the competition. Click OK. If I go to the folder, we can see now there's the original RAW folder, NERV. There is the converted NEF RAW picture to JPEG. And I've now cropped that. If you look at the amount of tile mark in the bottom right hand corner, it's been cropped to this version, which I've also renamed DJC-9079-10x8. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to repeat that again, but I'm going to do it 8x10 this time, portrait. So go back to the original picture, top left, right click, not the top open, come down, open with, select your editing software. There you can see the full image, lots of tarmac. And this time I'm going to do it in 8x10, which is selected there, but it's in these boxes that shows is it a landscape or portrait option. Click on the arrows in between. They swap over, and now up here, might have to draw it, left click, hold down. We can now go for the area of the picture. Again, I like this bottom left hand corner. I like that bit with yellows and some pinks coming in. I like that. Again, you can drag it around, resize it to suit you. Yep, that'll do for me. I like that one. And now what we can do, file, save as, check the save as type is JPEG, drop down box on the left if you need it. And I'm now going to change the name of this before the .jpg as dash. This time it's 8x10. Keep the quality as large as possible, but within the limits of 2 to 4 megabytes for the actual competition. So I'm just going to drag it to the left. 2 to 4, 3.5 sound good. Quality set at number 12. Okay, back to my folder. I'm just going to remove this one. I don't really need that. There we can see there's the RAW file converted to JPEG. The JPEG we changed a minute ago to 10x8, and we've also created an 8x10. You can see that's portrait. You can see that's landscape. Once more, because we can send the picture as 8x10, 10x8, or also square format. So I'm going to open the main picture again, open with Photoshop Elements. There she is. This time in the crop selections, I'm going to go to 5x5, which is the square format. Put my cursor on there. If it doesn't draw a box automatically, see the cursor's changed. I've put the cursor on the picture, hold the left mouse button down, drag it diagonally across and down, and there we can see we now got a square. I think you know I'm going to go in the left corner because I like the yellow. But how much of this green I remove and how much of the pinks, whites and reds flowers I can keep in is my decision now. I will go for that. Yes, I like that. Up to the top toolbar, file, save as. Change this time the name of the file to -5x5. Make sure the save as type is still JPEG, and then I'm going to save that. It's at 12, 5.8 megabytes. We need to bring it down to between 2 and 4. 11, 3.6. That sounds good to me. Okay, let's go to the folder. And we can see now, we'll just receive, when I'm viewing these pictures, what we can do in the view tab, I can choose how I see them. So I can see small icons, medium sized icons, large icons. And what we can see is that it changes sizes to show you the pictures. And if I leave it on this one, you can see There is the RAW. There's the JPEG copy of it. And then we cropped it the first time 10 by 8, cropped it the second time 8 by 10, cropped it the third time 5 by 5. Because we changed the file name, kept the number the same, but changed the aspect ratio added to it, we've got the same image cropped three different ways. And what we can do now is you can then go through looking at those pictures, decide which one you want to enter, or you can enter all three because you're allowed to enter three pictures as competition. The way I do it is I just click on the first one, it opens up the basic viewing system within the computer, and then I can go right and left through the three pictures and decide which one of the three I like to actually submit. Okay, so there's the three images. Let's say we want to submit, I've chosen the 5x5 format. What we need to do now is retitle the image for the competition. Okay, now what I do is save it now, right click. What we want to do, come down for the rename. Click on the rename. You can see the name of the actual image is in blue highlight, but not the .jpeg to the right, which is the file extension. So I'm just going to tap on my keyboard, because in the competition rules, it says we need to start off by typing the title as summer 17 dash, and then the title of your image. I'm going to call this one Golden Sun Heads, and then it's dash my name, Dave, space Chaplin. It's also a space between the names in the title, and that's it. Hit enter. So you can see Summer 17, Golden Sun Heads, Dave Chaplin. If I'm going to enter the other two pictures or a different one, but I'm going to do it, the example on these, I'm going to rename this one. Right click on it, come down to rename. On this one, still going to be Summer 17 dash. I'm going to give it a different title because it's a different image. Sunny corner of my garden. I'm stuck for sunny space corner space of space my space garden dash my name space Chaplin. Okay, and then we can see Summer 17 dash golden space sun space heads. Compare, oh, did it before. There we can see Summer 17 dash sunny space corner space of my space garden dash Dave space Chaplin. Okay, whether it's the same image or a different one, to rename it, right click on the image, come down to rename, delete the previous title. Again, it's got to start as Summer 17 dash, and the title of this one will be Mini Sunshine, Mini space Sun Shine dash my name space Chaplin. Enter. So there we've got my three images there with the correct file format. Now to check the file size, hover over it and it should then tell you, as you can see in that, it says this one's 3.68 megabytes, this one is 3.51, and this one is 2.93. So they all fall in with the 2 to 4 megabytes requirement, and they're all either 10 by 8, 8 by 10, 5 by 5 aspect ratio, and the title includes the Summer 17, the title, and your name. Okay, Summer 17, title, my name, and the same for the third one. Another way to check the file sizes is come up here and under the View tab, click Details. What we can see there, if I drag this across, you can see there's the three images. They're all JPEGs, and there it gives the file sizes there as well to make sure they meet the entry requirements for the competition. While we're here, you can just drag these across if you can. Depends on the size of your screen. This is quite a narrow monitor I've got here at the moment, but we can see we've got the file size. fat that one out. No, it won't let me do it anymore. Okay, to attach the image, we need to open up a blank email. I'm sending it from myself to Clips, myself, subject, summer, photo, competition. Hi, Dave, my winning entry. Can't spell today. Well, any day really. Regards me. Now, to attach the image, if you come up to the top or somewhere in this area, say insert. So I'm going to go to insert, paperclip for files, click on that, and this is where I choose then the actual image in the correct folder, and there's my three in my submissions demo folder. I've got the 5x5 golden sun heads. I attach that one first, so I click on it, highlight it, click open, and it then attaches it under the attachment to the email. Okay. All I need to do then is hit send. Okay, my email's come through. Here she is. There we can see I clicked on the picture. From me to me, my rubbish. There's the picture. I then right click on it. I save it. And I save it into my entries folder. Another one already there. Click save. Folder. And we can see there, there's the second image. I saved one earlier. And we can see the actual file size is within the right 2 to 4 megabytes of information.